Good morning, children. This is Nilanjana Bera, your art teacher. Hope you all are good and fine. And today we are going to do the watercolor flowers. For this, we need the color palette or the watercolor cake and brushes, along with the white sheet or the handmade sheet where you want to do the watercolor flowers. I'm using two tones, that is the lemon yellow and the chrome yellow. I'm just making the shade with the chrome yellow at the second level, and initially with the lemon yellow, just adding the chrome yellow at the bottom of the flower to give a little gradation. Even you can go for the different tones like red and yellow and orange and yellow, or the purple and pink tones. So it's depend upon you how you want, and try the different new techniques of the flower coloring. Now I'm just trying different arrangement of the flower, where maybe it's more like blooming or the bud. You can try on the different areas of the sheet just to make a bunch of the flower, or even for the cards or the greetings you can try this one. This is a wash technique where I'm just using the body of the brush to create the dimension there, and the tip is very sharp, so the round brush is the right for this kind of work. Even you can mix orange and yellow also to create a new tone, where you're just adding a little depth to that work. A second layer can be done once the first layer is dry, if required. Completely depend upon you. Otherwise, with a single stroke also you can work like this. Initially I'm just doing the flower or the bud, and then I'm just showing you how to create those leaves and branches with a single stroke. Just try to maintain the brush tip very fine and sharp. Now just see how to create the leaf here with a single stroke. See, I'm just touching the sheet with the tip and just dragging the brush by pressing the body of the brush, and just while lifting it, you need to twist the brush. Even blue and green can go well, or for lighter tones you can try the yellow and green, a mixture of both. Or while picking up the brush, you can just touch the brush in the second layer of the color. Suppose you're doing it with the green and with a dash of blue also, the grades of the coloring can be changed. Now just adding the stem to it. Make sure you're doing it just one behind the other. If the flower is coming in between, you have to maintain that space to create the stem there. And whatever the negative space is there, you can just fill up them with the brushes in the form of leaf. See, in the two direction I'm drawing it. One is from the upward, where I'm dragging the brush downward, and the other is the lifting of the brush. When you're lifting the brush, just try to maintain that. You need to twist the brush and remove it. Then it will give a sharp leaf technique or a leaf feeling. See, here I have used the dark tone, a blue and green tone I have used here. So you can try and experiment and try to do the work with different shades of pink, red, blue and purple. Even with some other technique of flower making, you can try them. These will look very beautiful in the card making. If you just try to create some kind of small greeting cards, and they look very appropriate, and see the gradations you can add and try. Thank you.